why Cincinnati, in a way, kind of scares me as an Alabama fan. Listen, every Alabama fan will definitely say that we're going to dominate Cincinnati, that the score is not even going to be close, that we're going to blow them out by 40, 50 points. I mean, I've seen some tweets about that. I mean, Vegas has Alabama as a 13.5-point favorite. And it's understandable, right? When you have the greatest coach of all time, Nick Saban, when you have the Heisman Trophy winner, when you have the probably arguably the best player in college football, Will Anderson and Jameson Williams, we have all, you know, the 5- and 4-star talent in the world. It's understandable why Alabama would be the 13.5-point favorite. You also beat Georgia, who for the most part, a lot of people had Georgia, you know, that this is the greatest defense of all time. And I kept saying that too. For weeks, I kept saying Georgia's going to go ahead, they're going to win the national championship, which that still is possible, but I kept saying that Alabama just doesn't have the Bama standard, and look what happened. I mean, you got into the SEC, everyone doubted Bama, and they absolutely just washed Georgia away. But now, again, the roles have been reversed for this game. Alabama's the one that is the favorite. They're the one that everyone's crowning. They're the one that's saying that, again, Alabama's going to wash Cincinnati. Cincinnati is a top four team. I think, again, they did beat Notre Dame. I definitely feel like that Cincinnati is definitely better than Notre Dame when they made it to the college football playoff back, during last season when Alabama had to play Notre Dame in the first round. But Cincinnati offers some challenges that I think Notre Dame just couldn't really bring to the table. They have a fast and athletic defense. They play with no fear. It's like they have nothing to lose. It's like they just say, you know what, fuck it. We have nothing to lose. We're just going to go ahead and just do our own thing. And again, when you're playing a team that has nothing to lose, I mean, look at Auburn. Auburn had nothing to lose against Alabama, and look how the way that they performed. Look how Florida. Florida played like they had nothing to lose, and Florida went ahead and almost beat Alabama. Right? A&M, same thing. Arkansas, same thing. LSU, same thing. Right? Alabama hasn't been invincible this year. Right? I'm not going to be one of those fans that's going to sit up here and say, well, Alabama's going to dominate the competition. Again, that could definitely happen. But I'm not that person to say it, you know, to say that until I actually see it on the field. Right? I was one of the people that said Ohio State could beat Alabama in the national championship because something just told me that, hey, Ohio State, they just feel like they have nothing to lose, right? They have all players that are going to be out. I felt like Ohio State had a certain type of advantage. And of course, I was wrong about that, and gladly I am wrong about that. But again, I'm one of those, pretty much the point is, I'm one of those fans that for the most part, I really try to look at everything objectively if I can. I don't try to use my bias to really clout my judgment when it comes to predicting and previewing teams. So I know some Bama fans will have a problem with me when it comes to that. But the point is that I just look at Cincinnati and I think that this is a team that can present Alabama with problems. Alabama isn't invincible. Again, Arkansas, LSU, A&M, Auburn. I mean, the list. Florida. The list goes on. I mean, Alabama has struggled with a lot of teams this year, and it's something that can honestly, it could happen in this game, right? Alabama turned. You know, some fans will say that they turned the corner, which could be true, but at the same time, they do have Alabama does have a track record of struggling, right? They dominated Ole Miss after everyone kept saying this was going to be Alabama's toughest test. Alabama went out and put on a clinic, and they did it against Georgia. Cincinnati, in a way, kind of does the same thing, where Cincinnati kind of, again, they play to their competition, right? Alabama plays to their competition. Alabama's the better team, in my opinion, going into this thing. Alabama's favorite. We all know this. I'm just a little worried that Alabama will play down to Cincinnati. And if they play down to Cincinnati, Cincinnati, I think, can win this game. Cincinnati's a team that, again, they play like they have nothing to lose. They play like with reckless abandon. They have playmakers all across the field, whether if it's on the offensive side of the ball or the defensive side of the ball. I like Beavers as a linebacker. That's a Ben Bolaware Skalski type of linebacker that somehow, some way, very intelligent football player. Not the most athletic, but a very intelligent, stout, runt, you know, right, downhill defender. I look at Sanders, who is an NFL draft prospect, who's probably not going to be a first-round pick, but I can see him being a second, third-round edge, guy coming off the edge. We all know that edge defenders can prevent Alabama's line with some challenges. I look at, again, Bryant and Gardner. Those are, you know, again, Gardner's going to be a first-round pick. Kobe Bryant is probably going to be a second or maybe a third-round pick. Right? They also have a safety. I forgot what his name is, but again, a very stout safety, very intelligent. Cincinnati doesn't make a lot of mistakes, guys. They just don't. They don't really make a lot of mistakes. They are very, very intelligent. They know how to fly to the football. Offensively, they know how to execute. They can be very explosive. They got some players on the outside that can present Alabama challenges. Alabama will be going against Wiley, who Alabama has struggled against tight ends. I mean, Jalen Whittemire, Brock Bowers. Hell, if you look at last year, when Alabama gave up almost 200 receiving yards to Ole Miss's tight end, Alabama has struggled with the tight end position. We don't have the best guys in man coverage or in zone with our linebackers and our star to defend against tight ends. So Cincinnati can present us with certain challenges that I think that as Alabama fans, we just can't overlook. We can't really underestimate in a way. I get it. Alabama is a 13.5-point favorite. Again, we have so many things going for us right now, but we can't be prisoners of the moment right now. I think as Bama fans, we really need to take a look at it and just kind of get back a little bit, right? We can't give Alabama the rat poison, and not in a positive way. And, you know, we're talking about the negative version of rat poison, right? This is what Nick Saban was kind of talking about, that, again, if there's any type of rat poison we want, it's the rat poison that doubts Alabama. That's the type of rat poison we want. We don't want the rat poison that's going to go Alabama's way as far as just, you know, everyone hyping them up and everyone saying they're going to win by 40, 50 points. Cincinnati, I think in this game, guys, they're going to have nothing to lose. Nothing to lose at all, right? If you heard Desmond Ridder's press conference, he sounded like a guy that just had nothing to lose. He's a guy that's simply just going to enjoy the moment. He's going to enjoy everything because this could be his last game. He sounds like a dude during his press conference that just sounded, he just had nothing to lose. Jerome Ford, the same thing, just sounded like a guy that just had nothing to lose. And that's a scary type of team to play. Very, very scary. Again, I think that this is going to be a good game. I don't think that this is going to be a blowout. If it is going to be a game where Alabama can take it away, it could be maybe the third or the fourth quarter. But I think that this is going to be a tough, competitive, physical football game. And I think this is going to be a game which could honestly make Alabama a better team if they do win, right? If the Crimson Tide do win this game, I think it's going to make them a lot better. I think Cincinnati is going to present Alabama with certain challenges as far as speed, athleticism, and just that competitive nature, that grit that we really haven't seen before. And honestly, I'm excited to play the Bearcats. They're a good football team. They have a lot of good NFL draft prospects on that football team right now. Luke Fickell's a hell of a coach. And I'm just, I feel like this is, we've never played, again, a non-group of five opponent in this stage as far as the playoffs since Utah. Remember, everyone thought that Alabama was going to destroy Utah. Look what happened. Utah whooped our ass. So not underestimating Cincinnati. This is a good football team. I'm excited to play them. Just good luck to them. Good luck to them, and we'll see what happens. But Friday, can't wait for it. Can't wait for it. But anyway, guys, Jan Sports, a.k.a. Jan 716, a little bit of a ramble, but it is what it is. I'll catch you guys in the next video, next reaction, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.